General, how is Oklahoma affected by the announcement of today from the Army?
As of now, they're not affected in any way that I know of, because there's going to have to be a lot of negotiation going on between the Secretary of the Army and the Governor before we can arrive at any change in the troop basis for Oklahoma.
What particular considerations will the Army keep in mind when they make a decision on what six National Guard units to do away with?
It's a little bit difficult to follow their thinking altogether, but I would imagine that they will take several things into consideration, namely the strength of the division, in all probability the past record of the division, at least back to World War II, and then the facilities that the units have to train in would be another factor. And then I imagine they would look over very carefully the number of commissioned officers we had and senior non-commissioned officers who had had combat experience.
How does the 45th stack up on these various points?
Very well, I would say, in all of them excepting one. Our strength is low, and it has been low ever since we came back and were reorganized following the Korean
Her statement has indicated to us that she has possibly been hiding in this shed since last Tuesday, which would be 5 days and 4 nights. And under those circumstances could very well be suffering from malnutrition and possibly exposure. The evidence that we were able to find from this interrogation indicates that we definitely shall hold her for suspicion of murder.